In this section, we will be discussing about a coherent MTI radar using a power amplifier and by using a power oscillator, and about non-coherent MTI radar and about the delay line cancellers. So this is a block diagram of a typical MTI radar with power amplifier. So in the earlier cases, we have seen an ordinary MTI radar which was not employing a power amplifier. Now in very noisy environments or high clutter is present, we have to go for MTI radar which is employing a power amplifier. Now the basic difference here is how the reference signal is being generated. Okay, so in earlier simple format, we had the reference signal to be given from a portion of the transmitter to the receiver side. But here the reference signal is being produced by a coherent oscillator. So the frequency is denoted as FC. And in addition to this coherent oscillator signal, which is providing as a reference signal to this receiver side, we are also having a stable local oscillator which is being employed here. Okay, so that frequency is denoted by the FL. So what do we do here is that we are going to combine this FL and FC in a mixer, and the addition frequency, that is FL and FC only, we are going to give it to a power amplifier and to a duplexer. And on the reception of the echo signal, obviously in the echo signal there will be a shift in the Doppler frequency will be introduced. So there will be shift in frequency. So depending upon whether it is moving away from the radar or it is coming towards the radar, we can have the sign of the Doppler frequency shift. So FL plus FC plus or minus FD will be now be mixed in a mixer. And to this mixer, we are also giving the input from our stable local oscillator, that is FL. So the output of the mixer will be the difference. So this FL value will get cancelled and we get only FC plus or minus FD. Okay. And now it is being fed to a IF amplifier and a phase detection. So here we do not employ amplitude limiters. We go for IF amplifier and the phase detection. And here for comparing the phase, we give a reference signal from that of our coherent oscillator. Okay, so the output from the phase detector will be the difference between the inputs, and at final we get the information about the FD, that is a Doppler frequency, which will be fed to the delay line canceller. The function of the delay line canceller we have seen in the previous section. So this is a MTI radar which is going to employ a power amplifier, and it can be employed even in the case of clutter and noisy environments. And the difference, main difference is here we are employing how we are going to take the reference signal from that of a coherent oscillator, and we also employ a stable local oscillator in this case, and we are employing here a duplexer, that is we have used a single antenna for both the transmission and the reception purpose. Now it differs in the way in which the reference signal is generated. That is the ordinary MTI radar with the MTI radar using a power amplifier. We have seen in the block diagram the way in which it generates the reference signal is different. Here the coherent reference, it is applied by a oscillator, and it is a stable oscillator whose frequency will be the same as that of the IF frequency which is used in the receiver. And the value of this FC, it will also be mixed with the stable local oscillator frequency, say FL. So FC and FL, they will be combined at the input side. Okay. And the RF echo signal, that is echo signal which we get back, that will be FL plus FC plus or minus FD. That is a Doppler frequency shift will be present in the echo signal. Again, it is heterodyned, or it is mixed in such a way with the local oscillator, that is our stable local oscillator, which is going to produce the IF signal. That is, we have seen in the block diagram, the echo signal received FL plus FC plus or minus FD, that is the echo signal. We are going to combine or mix it along with the stable local oscillator signal and then produce the IF signal, just as in the conventional super heterodyne receiver. So here, the reason why we are using the stable local oscillator and the coherent oscillator is mentioned. The characteristic feature of coherent MTI radar is that the transmitted signal must be coherent in phase with the reference signal in the receiver. So in the earlier cases or in the simple cases, we have provided a reference signal from the transmitter itself. But here the reference signal, we are providing it by using a separate coherent oscillator. Okay, and it should be stable. So here the coherence, the phase is being preserved. This is accomplished by the coherent signal, and the function of the stable local oscillator is to provide the transition, that is from the IF to the RF frequency, just like that in ordinary receivers. And any of the stable local oscillator phase shift, it will be cancelled on the reception. Okay, and the reference signal from the coherence and the IF echo signal, they are both fed into a mixer, which is called as the phase detector, and its output is proportional to the phase difference between the two input signals. So in the initial, in the input, we have mixed our local oscillator frequency and the coherent oscillator frequency, that is FL plus FC, we have mixed and we have transmitted. And on the reception of echo signal, obviously we get a Doppler frequency shift. So that is why we indicated FL plus FC plus or minus FD, and then what, we mix it. Okay, we mix it with our local oscillator. So we get at the output only FC plus or minus FD, because at the mixer we are getting a difference of the signals which is combined. So in there we actually mix it at the reception. It is like working like that of an ordinary receiver. So we get what, only FC plus or minus FD. Now this we are giving it to what? We are giving it to our IF amplifier and phase detection. That is, we do not employ here amplitude limiters. And the output of the phase detector, it will be the difference between the input signals. So here for reference, we are giving again the input from our coherent oscillator. Okay, so it will get cancelled, and the information which now we get at the output will only be what, FD, that is the information about our Doppler frequency, which we are going to supply it to our delay line canceller. So this is how this particular MTI radar with a power amplifier is going to work. Now the stable local oscillator, the coherent oscillator, and the mixer in which they are combined, plus any low level amplification, they are called as a receiver exciter. They find dual roles in both the transmitter and receiver. Now any type, say triode, klystron, traveling wave tube, or even closed field amplifier, any amplifiers working in the microwave ranges can be used as a power amplifier in case of MTI radar. And a transmitter which consists of a stable low power oscillator followed by a power amplifier is sometimes called as MOPA. It stands for Master Oscillator Power Amplifier. Now we have a MTI radar with power oscillator transmitter. So in that particular block diagram where we have employed a power amplifier, instead of that now we have employed here a magnetron oscillator. And in the oscillator, the phase of the RF, it bears no relationship from pulse to pulse. Okay, so we cannot generate here a reference signal from a continuous running oscillator. So a coherent reference signal, it may be obtained with the power oscillator by readjusting the phase of the coherent oscillator at the beginning of each sweep according to the phase of the transmitted pulse. So that is the main difference here. Okay, so there we have employed a continuous running oscillator, but in this case we need to what, readjust the phase of the coherence oscillator at each and every starting time of the signal. Okay, so each and every time we receive the echo, the phase of the coherent oscillator need to be adjusted. Okay, so the phase of the coherence is locked to the phase of the transmitted pulse each time a pulse is generated, because since in oscillator we are having no relationship of the phase from pulse to pulse. So we continuously require some means of locking mechanism by which there is what, a reference which is provided at the coherence to readjust the phase. Okay, so that it is becoming accordance with that of the transmitted pulse. So that is the difference here. So we are actually what, combining the signal from the transmission and the stable local oscillator, and we are mixing it. So same as that of the other case, we are having a stable local oscillator and a coherent oscillator, and here we are mixing it to produce a IF beat signal, and this IF beat signal is given as a reference for this of the coherent oscillator, so that the phase of the coherent oscillator is now being adjusted with this IF so that it becomes matched with that of the transmitted pulse, okay, so that it can be used as a reference here. And it compares the phase, and finally we give the information of the FD value to the delay line canceller. So a portion of the transmitted signal, it is now being mixed with the stable local oscillator output to produce a IF beat signal whose phase is directly related to the phase of the transmitter. So here the IF beat signal is produced, that is we are combining some portion of the transmitted signal along with the stable local oscillator output to get the IF beat signal, and this IF beat signal, the phase will be directly related to the phase of the transmitter. So this is applied again to the coherent oscillator in order to adjust, that is we are going to adjust the phase of the coherent CW oscillator to lock in step with the phase of IF reference pulse. So then we can relate it to the phase of transmitted pulse, and it may be used as a reference signal for echoes received from that particular transmitted pulse. Upon the next transmission of pulse, we are having here pulse transmission. So when the next pulse arrives, again another IF locking pulse will be generated. Another IF beat signal will be generated, and again it will be serving to relock the phase of the CW coherent oscillator until the next locking pulse comes along. So for each and every pulse, there will be locking, and there will be adjusting of the phase. That is a reference signal which is being produced. It will be related to that of the transmitted pulse. The phase will be maintained, or coherence is going to be maintained. Now we will see about a non-coherent type of MTI radar. Okay, so the principle of non-coherent MTI radar is that we are going to use the information from the clutter signal as our reference. So the echo signal from the clutter has a characteristics of transmitter signal, and it will be used as a reference to extract the Doppler frequency shift of the target echo signal. So in the block diagram, you can see that we are going to employ a power oscillator, for example, like a magnetron, and we are going to use a single antenna. We have a duplexer, transmit receive switch for transmitting and receiving. And in this, the information from the clutter signal from the environment is used as a reference in the receiver part. So there is no need for a phase detector or a phase canceller circuit in this part. We are going to use an amplitude detector, and its output can be given to cancellation circuits. Okay, so a radar that uses a clutter echo as a reference signal to extract the Doppler shifted target echo is called as a non-coherent MTI, also called as externally coherent MTI. We are going to use the information from the external environment. It is also possible to use the amplitude fluctuations to recognize the Doppler component produced by a moving target. So here we are going to see about the fluctuation, that is one which is produced by the moving target and the other one which is going to be produced from the clutter signal. So if we are observing that particular fluctuation, then we can come to an inference. So MTI radar which uses amplitude instead of the phase fluctuation is called as a non-coherent MTI radar. So in the block diagram, we have seen that we require only a amplitude detector and not a phase detector, because here the phase information is of no interest. So we will see some significance of a non-coherent MTI radar in this section, that is what is the difference here from the coherent MTI radar, and it is simple when you are comparing with that of the coherent MTI radar, that it is does not require first of all an internal coherent reference signal. So we have used here a clutter signal as a reference, and it does not require a phase detector also, and amplitude limiting is not employed in this case. We are using amplitude detector, but we are not using amplitude limiting circuits. Why? because we want to see about the amplitude variation or fluctuation between the moving target and the clutter signal. For example, if we are displaying, say, in a A scope, so we will be observing the butterfly figure, and we can see that how the amplitude is varying between the two signals, that is a clutter signal and the signal from that of a moving target. Okay, so that is what we have to observe. So we cannot employ amplitude limiting. And speaking about the IF amplifier, it has to be linear, or if a large dynamic range is required. And the detector which follows the IF amplifier is a conventional amplitude detector. And we are not using a phase detector, since it is of no interest in case of non-coherent radar. And local oscillator, it need not be that much stable as in the case of a coherent MTI. The transmitter also need not be that much stable as in the case of coherent MTI radar. So when you are comparing, this type of radar is more simple. But it has to be sufficiently stable, which means that there should not be any overlapping of all these clutter signals. So there must be sufficient time interval between the pulses. So it has to be sufficiently stable, but requirements are not as high as that of the coherent case. Okay, so the output can be followed by a MTI processor such as a delay line canceller. You can feed the output to a delay line canceller. So the Doppler component contained in amplitude fluctuation may also be detected by applying the output of the amplitude detector to a A scope. So when we are applying the output of the amplitude detector to a A scope, we can observe the butterfly modulation, we can observe the amplitude fluctuations as we have seen in the previous lecture. But in this case, the amplitude fluctuation is in such a way that they ride on the top of the clutter echoes. So from that we can extract the information. So except for the inclusion of means to extract the Doppler amplitude component, we are detecting what the amplitude component here. The non-coherent MTI block diagram is similar to that of a conventional pulse radar. The advantage is the simplicity. So it is attractive for application where space and weight is limited. But the chief limitation is that the target must be operating in a very large clutter signal environment if moving target detection is to take place. So now we have seen about both the coherent MTI radar and non-coherent MTI radar. Now the output of the MTI radar, we are feeding it to a delay line canceller. So now this delay line canceller, it acts as a filter. That is, it eliminates the echo clutters in receive signal and thereby improves the resolution of the target detection. So it can subtract the echoes from the successive signals. So for example, if you are giving the output from a MTI radar as an input to an analog to digital converter, so it will convert this to an appropriate digital value from the analog, and then we are subjecting it to a delay. Okay, say delay for a time period, pulse repetition time period of TP, or 1 by pulse repetition frequency FP. And then we are going to have a subtractor circuit for subtracting the original value from that of a delayed value. Okay, so now this difference value, now it is free from the echo signals, and this is converted into an absolute value and then applied to a digital to analog converter, which can be fitted into a suitable output for display. So it can be properly displayed. So this is a concept of delay line canceller, that is, it will subtract the echoes, that is the echo which is received from the clutters, from the noisy environment, from the successive signals by producing a delay. Okay, so we consider here the subtraction of the original one and the delayed signal. So from the successive signals, it will subtract the echoes. So because of its periodic nature, the filter can also reject the energy in the vicinity of the pulse repetition frequency and its harmonics. The signal from a range at a target of R0, the output of the phase detector can be given as. So here we are having the subtraction of the two signals, that is V1 and V2. So V1, we can represent it as K sine 2 pi FDT minus of phi naught, where K can be the amplitude and phi naught is the phase shift. Okay, FD we know, it is a Doppler frequency information. So we are considering here a moving target. So obviously we will be having a Doppler frequency. And again, we consider the signal from a previous transmission, say which is delayed by a time period of T, pulse repetition interval. Okay, so the delayed signal now we are considering. So in the T factor, it has to be multiplied by TP or T. Okay, so T here is a TP or the pulse repetition interval. So what are we going to subtract in the subtractor circuit? We are going to subtract this V1 and V2. So everything else is assumed to remain essentially constant over the particular time of interval, that is pulse time period interval, so that what happened, the amplitude K is same for the pulses. So the output for the subtractor we can consider. So the output V is equal to V2 minus of V1. Okay, so when we are doing the subtraction of both the signals, we get as such. So we have to apply here the trigonometrical identity of sine A minus sine B. Okay, sine A minus sine B can be expressed as 2 sine A minus B by 2 cos of A plus B by 2. So here I have written additional steps for better understanding, because if you directly see the result, you may not understand. So here we will apply here the trigonometrical identity and solve it. So solving it further, so proceeding with the subtraction here, we get as such. Now when we are considering only the magnitude, we get V is equal to 2k sine pi fd tp cos of 2 pi fd t minus pi fd tp minus phi. So we can consider this as h of f into cos of 2 pi fd t minus pi fd tp minus phi, where h of f is this particular value, that is 2k sine pi fd tp. Okay, so we understand here that the output from the delay line canceller, it will be what? The output will be a cosine wave which is having, say, an amplitude value of 2k sine pi fd tp. Okay, so the output is a cosine wave having this particular amplitude, 2k sine pi fd tp. So the amplitude value of the output, it is depending on what all factors? It is depending on the Doppler frequency fd and the pulse repetition time period, or even pulse repetition frequency also we can say. So the amplitude depends upon fd and tp. Okay, so the delay line canceller, it is acting like actually a filter. So the filter, it is going to, say, reject or cancel out the DC components from the clutter. Okay, the magnitude of the relative frequency response of the delay line canceller. So when we are considering the magnitude of this H of F, that is, it is a ratio of amplitude of the output from the delay line canceller. This is our amplitude 2k sine pi fd tp, which we have seen. When we are comparing to the amplitude of a normal radar video, it will be as such. Okay, so this is our amplitude of our output from the delay line canceller. So it will be a cosine wave with a particular amplitude as such, which will be depending upon Doppler frequency fd and pulse repetition time period tp. So now we have seen about the concept of a delay line canceller, that is, it is acting like a frequency rejecting filter. Okay, so we have considered here its frequency response h of f, amplitude as such, the output or the subtracted value which is coming out from the delay line canceller. Now, there is a term to be understood, that is a blind speed, which is a disadvantage of delay line canceller. So that is a case when the target will not be detected, or there will be a interference from the cluttering signal. There is an uncancelled clutter signal may occur in a delay line canceller, which will be difficult in that time to detect the target properly. It will interfere with the target detection process. Now in the previous case, we have seen about the response from a single delay line canceller. There the amplitude value was 2k sine pi of fd tp. Now if this argument value is in the order of, say, 0 pi 2 pi radians, we know that since it is a sine, what happens, this value will become 0. So the Doppler frequency shift in the presence of clutter, so in this particular output of the single delay line canceller, we can define it as fd is equal to nfp for n varying from integer 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So how this is got? We have equated For example, the argument value that is in the amplitude 2k sin pi fd dp. So the value pi fd tp, if it is equal to plus or minus n pi. Okay, so in that case, what will be fd? It will be nfp. And the general equation for the Doppler shift frequency, we already know, that is fd is equal to 2fd vr by c. That is a general equation for the Doppler shift frequency. So now we are going to equate both the equations. That is a Doppler frequency shift due to the clutter signal and the general equation for the Doppler frequency shift. When we are equating these equations 1 and 2, we can also replace C by FT to be lambda, and then further proceeding we get the value for VR is equal to N lambda by 2 TP. So this is the velocity for calculating the blind state. That is, there is a presence of clutter signal which is going to interfere with the target detection process. So in that time, how to calculate the velocity is given. So the possible methods by which we can reduce the effect of blind speed is to operate the radar at a longer wavelength and operate with a very high pulse repetition frequency and operate with more than one repetition frequency and operate with more than one radio frequency. So these are some of the methods by which we could reduce the error due to the blind speed. So in this particular section, we have seen about coherent MTI and non-coherent MTI, and then seen about the delay line canceller and a blind speed occurring in a delay line canceller.